everyone. We're here doing a follow-up video to our control pollination video for walnut. And we have some full sibling seeds that came from a walnut cross last year. Daniel by Hay. So Daniel was the female parent, Hay the pollen parent. And you could see a radicle poking out. So these have been in stratification in about 34 degrees in our soil mix. And there should be a still image in this video of what our soil mix looks like. And after about, they say they have a very long stratification period. And after 1 year of stratification, we'll pull out, which means about 150 days in this case, pull out all the seeds that have radicles emerged and those that haven't germinated yet or shown signs of like shell splitting and radical emergence. We'll go back into the cooler for a few months. We'll start everything out just for sake of getting all of the seed out of stratification quickly, putting seeds in these small tree bands. You can see they're about 4 inches deep. And then later we'll pot everything up into 10 inch tree bands that are 3 to 4 inches in diameter. So here we've filled in most of the bands with the soil mix, which has three types of fertilizer in it, again in the still image. Up to about an inch from the top, and we've compacted and like packed everything in. That's an important step. You don't want loose media when planting seeds or seedlings. And then we'll bring everything out of the bag that has radicles and plant them. And here you can see the radicle or the root emerging. And in a few days, once it's been established in the greenhouse, you'll begin to see the shoot emerging from a similar location. So we're just staging all of our germinating seeds now, and then we'll go in to try to be a little bit more throughput, and then the next phase will be planting them all. If the shells are starting to split, that's a sign that the radicle is about to emerge. So you can see some separation occurring. It's a little bit dirt filled. But you can see the shell is beginning to split and the coloration change in the nut. So the radicle will emerge from this. And so this will be the something that's planted as well. If there's no split in the shell, then we'll put it off to the side and put it back in stratification. So we're getting a pretty good germination rate. The main limitation to germination rate in walnut is maintaining the right amount of moisture in storage. And keeping them in there long enough. So it does seem like a prolonged, compared to other temperate tree nut species, a prolonged germination is quite helpful. That meaning like, you know, 100 days is a good benchmark for some species. You know, chestnuts, for example, you'll get a high germination rate if you just stick a bag of them in the refrigerator for 80 to 100 days. Walnuts, the germination rate will be quite low at that stage. And so keeping them in almost for like a double stratification, so to speak, is quite helpful. You could see nearly all of the nuts, maybe with the exception of just several out of this 30 or so nuts here, are germinating. So we're up in like the probably mid to upper 80 percentile, and that's excellent for a breeding program's purposes. Again, connecting it back to the goals of a breeding program, as it said in the pollination video, we're basically looking at complementary hybridization, where we're trying to combine preferred traits from both the female and male parent into given offspring. To do that, we want to have a certain volume of offspring per cross. And so if we can get into the like 75 to 125 range of offspring per cross, then we can kind of meet our goals in finding those unique recombinants a part of the family, may I say like 10% of the family that carries the majority of traits from both mom and dad in a given individual. Again, that number will kind of change based on breeding goals and like the genetic architecture of breeding goals, but just as a generic thought process, that's what we're looking at here. And good germination could be a rate limiting step to meeting those goals in a breeding program. So at this point, we're just trying to make sure that we're not damaging the radicle and that it's orientated appropriately at the sufficient depth. We're basically we'll top cover these and just kind of press it in gently, but we're putting these pretty much near the soil surface, especially after it gets watered and the soil, you know, drops down a little bit into the bands. So we'll just give these a gentle cover and then pack it in a little bit. Again, gently. Another thing, if you are stratifying walnut seeds, say you're doing some on-farm breeding, some hobbyist breeding, what you could do if you have like a lower germination rate after a prolonged stratification is put a chip into the shell. A colleague at the breeding program at UC Davis suggested that to use a dog's toenail clippers. And so you could put a chip into the shell and basically soak them in water over the weekend to rehydrate them, and that should push germination. So now we'll just pause and we'll take this flat into the greenhouse and put it next to the other offspring of the breeding program and water them in thoroughly.